So if you like to shoot Asian carp, it's hard to be proficient if you don't practice. As you know, I like to shoot things flying, whether it's a dove, pigeon, duck, or maybe a target or an Asian carp. It's exciting. And that's what I'm doing today. I'm practicing for bow fishing for Asian carp. It's time and time again, shooting moving targets. I use the Laporte archery system. This is a pretty cool device right here. Throws targets up in the air, and it's made for shooting, you know, with your bow and arrow. What a brilliant invention for guys like me who want to do a lot of shooting at moving objects. So anyway, we're gonna take the Laporte fire up here and do a little bit of shooting and practice for Asian carp.
I've got flu arrows, and I shoot bare fingers. It's the only way to shoot birds, fish, or even flying targets.
Oh, shot his head off.
The flight of the arrow has always intrigued me. It always seems to have a mystical power when I let her fly.
And these birds are high today, 40 yards.
For as it crosses the sky, it tracks its quarry, and I am always fascinated when it meets the mark.
I love it. You're watching Relentless Pursuit. The slocks won't stop coming. I love it. We got big fish jumping today. You never know when one will take you out of the boat. All right, we're getting ready to head for the fish now. We got a lot of structure along the bank here. This is the Imaquan Marsh over beside us. And they've dumped rock in the water when they built the levee. So all that rock over the years has tumbled into the river, and it's along the edge. It breaks up the current, makes an eddy behind the rocks in the current, so the fish find shelter in slower water. And this is where they start jumping.
They can feel the vibration of the boat. And the more rickety your motor and boat, the better they jump. When they leave the water, they're really trucking. And they're hard to hit. But not for Clint. He snapshot this one. That's hard to do. Because when they come out of the water, the average fish is only airborne for about a second. And there's others that get some real hang time.
Snapshot.
These fish thrive on murky water. That's why they're so abundant in the Illinois River. They swim in huge schools. With their mouths open, they're filtering the water for microorganisms. They're competing for food with native species like the spoonbill and gizzard shad. But they're a real boon for predators like gar, catfish, pike, and bass. Of course, rednecks like them too.
What a shot! Holy cow! That was a great shot right there.
But it's dangerous. So you gotta keep your gear in secure cases. For you have to troll in shallow water to make them jump. However, when you're in that shallow water, you never know when you're gonna hit a submerged log. So the danger is real, but the adventure is worth the risk. It's a lot like freedom. The cost is high, but we'll never give it up.